I'm Buddy Jewell. I'm a singer-songwriter here in Nashville, Tennessee. I'm originally from Mosey Hill, Arkansas, and I've been here for 16 years. I spent about 10 years in Nashville trying to get a record deal and never could get anyone to sign me. And then a little TV show came along called Nashville Star back in 2003, and I was the first one to win it.
You're like a neon sign, a cold beer, a sawdust floor. You are country music, buddy. You sing your butt off. Our very first Nashville star is Buddy Jewell.
After that, my career kind of skyrocketed. I had a big hit with a song called Help Pour Out the Rain, Lacey's song that I wrote for my daughter.
Lord, when I get to heaven, can I taste the Milky Way? I don't want to come to visit, cause I'm coming home to stay. And I can't wait to see my family and meet Jesus face to face. Do you think, Lord, you could use another angel to help pour out the rain? Can I help pour out the rain?
My debut album on Columbia Records debuted at number one on the country charts and went gold about 6 months later. And we soon released my second single, which was called Sweet Southern Comfort. And that found its way up in the top five as well.
From Carolina down to Georgia, smell the jasmine and magnolia, sleep the sweet home.
You know, my first album was a big success. Unfortunately for me, the thing that got me my record deal probably kind of cost me my record deal as well. In winning Nashville Star, from what I understood, the folks that owned the TV show also owned half of everything that Sony made off of me album sale-wise. So they were spending all this promotion money, only getting about half of it back. And so in 2005, Sony made a good business move, and I agreed with them. They decided that they would take their money and put it behind somebody they could keep 100% of the revenue on instead of 50%. Makes sense to me. In 2008, I started my own record label called Diamond Dust Records, and my first offering on that label is a CD entitled Country Enough. My very first single is kind of a controversial little tune called This Ain't Mexico. It's something that a buddy of mine, Al Sostrin, and I decided to write back in 2006, and it's our way of addressing the problem with illegal immigration in the U.S. I've caught a little flack over that song, but if you really listen to the lyrics, you hear that all we're trying to say is, hey, we don't mind anybody being here, just be here legally and follow the same rules that we do.
This ain't Mexico. Sorry, partner, but we don't upload. You want to live here, there's a line, get in it. You can call me a closed-minded, old-fashioned, flag-waving, redneck gringo. But this ain't Mexico.
I've been spending a lot of time the past few months writing, concentrating on a couple of projects that I want to try to get out this year. Now, the first one is a gospel album. I've had a lot of requests from my fans for that. And also, I'd like to do a Christmas CD as well, so look for those in the coming months. Plan on seeing us out on the road. Check out my tour schedule at my website, buddyjewell.com. You can also see that at myrecordlabel.net/buddyjewell, and I've got a MySpace page, myspace.com/buddyjewell.